Hello, I am Mona Sazgar, a clinical professor in the Department of Neurology Comprehensive Epilepsy Program at the University of California, Irvine. I am an epileptologist treating patients with epilepsy, and my passion is providing comprehensive care for women with epilepsy. Let me introduce you to the UCI Comprehensive Epilepsy Program and tell you who we are. We are a level 4 center of excellence in epilepsy care, recognized and certified by the National Association of Epilepsy Centers in the United States. We use a multidisciplinary team of subspecialties, including 4 epileptologists, 2 epilepsy-trained neurosurgeons, neuropsychologists, and neuroimaging experts to offer medical and surgical treatment for epilepsy. We are the only academic epilepsy program in Orange County. Let me start with defining what seizure is. The brain works with electricity, and the brain cells communicate with each other through electrical messaging. Seizure is like having a short circuit. A seizure occurs when there's an abnormal surge of electricity in one part of the brain, as in focal seizures, or in the entire brain, as in generalized convulsions. A seizure is a symptom, not a disease. Seizures are common, affecting 10% of the population, and may result from anything such as low sugar, excessive alcoholic beverage use, or alcohol withdrawal, infections, certain medications, or other toxins. Epilepsy, on the other hand, is a chronic neurologic disorder and is characterized by recurrent seizures. An epileptic brain can create seizures independent of the circumstances. It is the third most common neurologic disorder after stroke and dementia. Epilepsy affects 1% of the population, and in the United States, that adds up to 3 million people. Half of the affected population are women, so approximately 1.5 million women in the United States have epilepsy. Of those, 24,000 give birth each year. 2 published surveys of healthcare professionals in the United States discovered that the majority did not even know that sex hormones can affect seizures in women with epilepsy, and that seizures and seizure medications may increase sexual and reproductive disorders. Many could not tell which seizure medication caused contraceptive failure. Women with epilepsy face a number of challenges unique to their gender, starting from puberty to menses to birth control, conception, pregnancy, childbirth and child care, and menopause. A comprehensive epilepsy care should take into account and address the unique problems in each stage of a woman's life. The 2 main sex hormones in women are estrogen and progesterone. These sex hormones can change the excitability of the brain. Estrogen is the bad hormone, resulting in increased seizure frequency clinically and increased epileptiform discharges in the brain. Progesterone, on the other hand, is a good hormone. It protects against seizures. Similarly, seizures can also affect the sex hormone production. They do so by affecting brain structures in the HPO axis. HPO stands for hypothalamus, pituitary gland, and ovaries. The chemicals responsible for regulating sex hormones are produced in the brain, in hypothalamus, and pituitary gland. Seizures may disrupt the release of sex hormones, affect ovulation, result in anovulatory cycles, and infertility. One deep brain structure called amygdala, which is highly involved in epilepsy, has connections with the HPO axis. Hyperexcitability of amygdala, which occurs in epileptic brain, can result in disruption of sex hormone production and affect ovulation and fertility in women with epilepsy. You may not know that the rate of birth in epileptic women is 1/3 or 1/4 of general population. In women with catamenial epilepsy, seizures fluctuate with menstrual cycles. There may be significant increase in seizure frequency and severity at the time of ovulation due to a surge in estrogen, or around the time of menstruation when there is a drop in progesterone levels. In some women with abnormal ovulation, the seizures may worsen for the entire second half of their cycle. Catamenial epilepsy is reported in about 30 and up to 70% of women with epilepsy. Catamenial epilepsy is diagnosed by asking women to use their basal body temperature or ovulation kits to chart their menstrual cycle and to determine whether their seizures cluster around certain time of their menstrual cycle. The current treatment options for women with catamenial epilepsy is to target the days that the seizures cluster during their menstrual cycle by either supplementing some medications such as acetazolamide, clobazam, clonazepam, or progesterone lozenges. With certain medications, it may be safe to prescribe higher doses of their own medications at the time of seizure exacerbation during menstrual cycle. But what about the birth control in women with epilepsy? Certain seizure medications listed here can cause failure of birth control pills and result in unplanned pregnancy. Women on these medications should be made aware of such risk. Other medications listed here do not cause contraceptive failure. In women with epilepsy who are taking seizure medications with risk of birth control failure, they should be prescribed higher estrogen component in the birth control pill, greater than 50 microgram. If using Depo-Provera injections, the injections should be done more often. Mini pills and progestin-only tablets will not work to prevent pregnancy in these women. And the method of choice recommended by most epileptologists is using intrauterine devices, either with or without progesterone release. Seizure frequency may worsen during pregnancy in up to 35% of women with epilepsy. In about 10%, there may be some improvement in seizure frequency during their pregnancy. The rest of women with epilepsy show no changes in their seizures. Seizures in pregnant women can result in tenfold increased risk of injury or mortality in both mother and unborn baby. So stopping seizure medications may not be a wise option. But what about the effect of seizure medications on the baby? The risk of major problems such as heart or brain defect in general population is about 2 to 3%. That means pregnancy by itself can carry a risk. Seizure medications may or may not cause additional risk. So far, the data collected by the North American Pregnancy Registry indicates that the highest risk is with valproic acid, and that's in the range of 10.7%. I've also listed the rest of the known risks with seizure medications in this slide, including phenobarbital in the range of 6.5%, carbamazepine 3%, phenytoin 2.9%, and lamotrigine 1.9%. Many women wonder about the safety of breastfeeding while on seizure medications. If the baby is already exposed to the medication during pregnancy, then the consensus is that the benefits of breastfeeding will outweigh the additional risk of passing the medication to the baby through the breast milk. This slide shows that the breastfeeding is considered to be safe if the infant exposure index is less than 10%. And it also shows which medication have high exposure index and should be avoided. I want to summarize by emphasizing how important it is to educate the healthcare professionals about the challenges that women with epilepsy face in their lives. If they follow proper recommendations, the vast majority of women with epilepsy will live a full life and give birth to healthy, normal children. In the end, I want to introduce you to our dedicated team for the fight against epilepsy. And if you would like to know more about this subject, here are two of my recent publications. One is a review chapter in Management of Epilepsy in Women, and the other one is a book published by Springer, Controversies in Caring for Women with Epilepsy, which me and Dr. Cynthia Harden have edited. I want to thank you so much for your attention. And also, if you have any other questions, please do not hesitate to contact us at the Comprehensive Epilepsy Program and visit our website.